because I have never been more confused in my life. This little talk, and I've lived in a bubble. I ain't gonna lie to you. Every day I woke up, I go to work. I come home, I provide for my family, I cook, I clean, I do laundry. I sign the back of the check, he pays the bills, that's all I know. And it's all over. That world don't exist anymore. And it's really hard to understand anything. I try to pretend, but pretending doesn't work because it's not real, and if it ain't real, it don't feel right, and everybody's like feeling weird and shit, you know. I don't know. I wouldn't wish this pain on anybody. I really wouldn't. And I hate a lot of people. This is just something that you just gotta live through, you know? It's just something you gotta get through, and that's all there is to it. And you just gotta keep going. You sit in this chair day in, day out, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. Because that's all you know. Without your life, you don't know how to do anything. In my mind, I think I'm living, you know, I think I'm breathing and doing, but I don't know how to live without doing what I used to do, you know. I feel so empty inside, and I feel like an egg without anything inside of it. I feel like people are like, hey man, you can do this now. I don't know. I ain't gonna do nothing yet. Cause I don't know, I've been sitting in this chair for 2 years. I reckon I'll sit in it for another 2 years. So I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. I know. I go to bed. wake up. I go to bed. Wake up. I go to bed. I'm pretty good at that. I don't give a fuck either. One, two, three, four. Got 12 ice cubes in this. How many people count ice cubes in your drinks? I got some kind of Carmex or something on this. That's okay. I don't know, man. I don't give a fuck. I come for you. A little bit of blood. That's alright. That's alright. Thank you. say alright, like I know what the fuck I'm doing. Oh shit. I just said deja vu. Oh god. It's not good. Not good. Bum, 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 bum. I'd be happy if I had this fucking bra off. Let's just go ahead and take it off. It's like, I don't know, it'd be like a guy sitting in, oh. Be like a guy sitting in Jock's trap all day. It's just so tight. It feels good, but I don't know. I'm watching chat now. I just, Nikki, I don't know, man. What's going on? Is everything okay? What really blows my mind is that they bother you more than they bother me. They don't bother me. I don't give a fuck what they say. Really. Don't care about me. Don't care about me. I'm just somebody that sits in a chair all day. I'm alright. Ain't nothing gonna happen to me. I'm alright. You know what I'm saying? Get the fuck out of here, you little cunt. I'm alright, man. Seriously. I get to drinking a little heavy and I think thoughts and I'm allowed to think them. Hopefully. Nobody's gonna beat me up over that, right? And I keep going forward, you know. As hard as it may be, I keep doing it. Well, if you don't think that I'm suffering, 8:37. You can suck my ass. Because I'm here to tell you, I'm one of the quiet ones. And unless I'm absolutely fucking wasted, you'll never see this from me. I don't do this very often. My drunk-a-logs are very few and far between. So when you get a chance to see them, you should be fucking grateful. Because it's real talk. I ain't got a reason to lie to you. I've been sitting in this goddamn fucking chair for a long time. And y'all say, go outside, get some sun, go see the fresh air or whatever. I don't know how to do that. I don't know how to do anything, really. So just shut the fuck up, suck my ass, and leave me alone. That's pretty much all you gotta do. Why don't you move your fucking computer? Why don't you get off your fucking fat ass 162? You son of a bitch, you think you're fucking all that? You ain't shit, man. Leave me alone. Fucking tell me you'd move my computer. Fuck you. Why don't you move your fucking mind out in the fucking outer space or something? Leave me fucking alone. Your ass is as fat as the fucking, I don't know, Big Mac. Just leave me alone. Up every day, you know, you pull the covers off and you're like, hey man, let's go. I can't do that kind of stuff. I've got limitation and boundaries that I've got to obey every day of my life. And that's real talk, man. Y'all think I'm just a drunk and a piece of shit. But I'm telling you the truth. I'm not lying to you. And it's real talk. I can't do anything, really. So I just sit in my chair, and I'm pretty much got used to it. After 10 years, I don't know anybody that couldn't. Is Nancy Jane here? Is she still here? Nancy. Miss Vicky's hurting. Just a little bit. But I'll be all right, girl, I promise. If anybody can do this, it's me. Right, gal? I'm one tough cookie. Yeah. I just can't believe. That I showed myself on camera with him. Oh, man. Oh, no. Oh, no. I don't know, I could have done it, man. Oh, let's see if we can buy a song. I don't know. I think I'm pretty priceless.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Isn't that the best? Isn't that the most beautiful song you ever heard in your fucking life? It's really pretty. Yeah. That's what's going on. How you know? What's this? Is it by the Scorpions? I don't know. I don't know if it's by a scorpion or not. Well, all I'm gonna say is y'all don't understand nothing. I know y'all think you do. You sit in your shout boxes or shit boxes and you won't even sign into my channel and give me an ounce of respect. But you know what? That's okay. Cause I don't care no more. I can promise you I will sit in this chair for another year, pretty much. Doing the same thing I did yesterday, today. Probably not as drunk though. I don't get this drunk too often. Every once or two, 3 months, I get this drunk. I'm not proud of it. I drink every day, but I don't get drunk every day. 257. That's real talk. I know. But I'm pretty fucking smashed right now. I can always go visit Nancy Jane. Well, I had an invitation, but I'm not getting on no fucking jet plane. I can't. If I get on a jet plane, I'm going to see Tommy. And that's about it. Other than that, I'm just going to die in my bed, pretty much. That's it. I ain't got no interest in going to fancy places and none of that shit. I want to meet Tommy. I want him to know that I'm a real person. And that I'm a good girl. And I'm not a whore. And I ain't. And one day, the man's going bald, waiting for me to get up there. I mean, the dude's done fucking. He's lost half his hair since I saw him. It's just. I don't know. I just want to shake his hand and say, hey, man, I was really real, you know? I wasn't just some battle cam chick, you know? I was really real, Tommy. You know? He is evil. He is, but so am I. I don't want to go to prison if I go up there and meet him, you know. I mean, I go right down there to fucking Atlanta Airport, boom, get on a fucking jet plane and be there tomorrow. Real talk, man. I just don't want to go to jail. I just don't want to go to jail. Down here in the South, you just if you want to meet somebody like the crush that I have on Tommy, you just go to the next door and go. You knock on the door, the guy opens up the door, you say, hey, what's going on? How you doing? And he'll look at you and go, what? And I'd say, hey, I live next door. And he's like, okay, how you doing? And then you just said, I just want to introduce myself, and you walk away. That's it. You get back in the plane and you come back home, you know. But just to shake his hand, you know, so he knows I'm real. So he knows I never lied to him. You know, Bruce was bad enough. And then I gotta tackle Tommy too. I just can't do it, man. I'm telling you folks, I'm not that strong. I really wish I was, but I'm not. Content in a place I regret. I found you find strength in your moments of weakness. I won't have peace with myself. I've been burdened with blame, trapped in the past for too long, and I'm moving on. And I know all the faces. Each one is different, but they're always the same. They mean me no harm, but it's time that I face it. They'll never allow me to change. But I never dreamed home would end up where I don't belong. How you doing?
I had to lose everything.
When Bruce sold a condo in Florida and a boat and the house in Hampton, I knew, you know, man, you just know stuff. Folks, man, let me tell you something. I've been with a man for 25 years, divorced, still living with the motherfucker. You touch his body, you know. You touch his body. And it's like touching heaven. If there's such a thing. I used to love him. And I ain't in love with him. I don't want to make love to him. I don't want to kiss him. I don't want anything. And it's been that way for years. But the fact that Bruce has stood by my side speaks volumes. And, I don't know, man. Any personal plan. You know what? Let's just go ahead and drink this whole bottle of liquor and get it over with. You know what I'm saying? Let's just do it. I'm ready. I can do it. Anybody can do it, it's me. Right? I'm not gonna call Tommy.
You don't even know my day right now. I was having lunch with Becky.
So, I have some news. Dale asked me to marry.
I will kill myself before I call that somebody. That's real talk.
She put him out.
Like the burning end of a midnight cigarette. How you doing?
She broke his heart.
He spent his whole life trying to forget.
We watched him drink
his pain away a little at a time.
But he never could get drunk enough to get her off his mind until.
Put that bottle to his head and pulled the trigger.
And finally drank away her memory.
Oh!
Life is short, but this time it was bigger than the strength he had to get up off his knees. We found him with his face down in. With a note that said I love her till I die. And when we buried him beneath the willow,
the angel sang a whiskey lullaby.
La 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 la
la. I miss you, Mom.
La, 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 la.
But she never could get drunk enough to get him off her mind until the night. She put that bottle to her head and pulled the trigger.
No way to fly, and the clouds.
can we be? So far between where we are and one more try. And anyway,
me and Bruce was floating by. First airplane. The first time he kissed me, I thought I was going to die. Everything that I'm saying to you is everything I gave up for Tommy. You know? And then I have to consequently deal with that in my brain too. Hey, Clay Davis, it's good to see you, sweetheart. I'm not doing too good, man. I'm pretty fucked up. I'm gonna be straight up with you, Clay. But I went through all this in my mind when I met Tommy, you know, and I told Bruce everything. I was like, this is everything that I'm thinking. People on the internet can be really, 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 really bad. And you gotta be very careful. Cause you can get hurt really bad. I'm just telling you straight up. Too much I can say besides that. Because folks can get really. He said everything. He said everything to me, all the right things to say, you know, and I just believed everything. Takes me a long time. Hell, I ain't even over Bruce yet, and I'm still crying over Tommy. You know, it takes me a long time to get over someone that I love, and I can't help it. I can't help it. I wish I could fix it. I wish there was a switch that you could turn on and off and say, Vicky, don't feel that way no more. But I can't. But there ain't no switch. I truly believe that boy loved me. And I thought he was kind of like Bruce, you know. So I ain't got many teachers in my life. I've only been with one man, so I thought Tommy was kind of like Bruce. I thought that maybe he loved me instantly too. But Tommy is so different than Bruce because Tommy's like, he's different. He's like, if I say what he's like, then I'm going to degrade Bruce. So I'm not going to say what he's like because I want to hurt Bruce. And God knows I don't want to hurt Tommy either. So fuck it. Just leave me alone. Everybody shut the fuck up. I ain't even in my right mind. I'm not even in my left mind. Fuck. Shit. I think I'm just gonna go wash my hair. That's what I'm thinking. Nancy Jane, is anybody fucking here that can mod this channel? Really, can I see somebody put their hand up? I need some mods. Okay, Nancy, mod this channel. I'm gonna go wash my hair. Just to make myself feel a little better. Oh, yeah. My heart is so fucking breaking right now. I can't even fucking think straight.
Thank you.
but I think the hardest thing for me to swallow is I don't know, man. You can drink until you're into oblivion, and it doesn't make it feel any better. But when a man says the things that Tommy said to me, you know, and he knew I was going through heartache with Bruce, I don't know, man. I don't know. And I sit here and I get drunk and I think about it day in and day out, and I'm like, how could a guy do that, you know? How could a guy say what he says, you know, and hurt people? Like he hurts people, I don't know. I'm just, you know, I guess I'm just one of them women that I guess I'm a freak. 'Cause I don't understand love like y'all do. Probably never will. Don't care to either. I don't want to lay on my back for a living, and don't want to even fathom that idea. I just think that a man is a man, and he's supposed to like do what a man does. And I thought that Tommy was going through some heartache because he said he lost his Shannon and shit, you know. And I was trying to be there for him and shit. And I told him to clean his face up and clean his clothes, clean his house up. He did everything I told him to do, everything. And I wasn't trolling him, I really meant it. And he really did it. And he did it on cam, you know. And I don't know what happened, you know, between here and there. Everything got, I don't know. I just wish he'd call me and tell me, Vicky, I trolled you. Vicky, I trolled you. And then I'll be over it, you know. Vicky, I told you. You're the laughing stock of the neighborhood, man. I told you, Vicky. Then I can live with that. I can live with that. I can't. But to think and then sit here and know what I gave up for that motherfucking worthless piece of shit. You know, I just need something. Something. You know. Anything right. I just need something. Because, folks, I swear to God, I don't know how a man can do this to a woman, and I just don't know. And all the ugly things that I say about him, I don't really mean them. I just say them because I'm gonna go wash my hair, you know? Excuse me. Yeah, I'll get in a bed tonight. I'll lay down. I'll put my legs out there and everything. Just lay on the bed. And I'll be like, what the fuck's going on here? And I try to pretend, but I'm not good at it. And I don't give a shit. I don't care. I wish I did, but I don't. I'm so tired of being by myself that I don't even want to be by myself anymore. You know? I am so tired of waking up every fucking day to everything that anybody could ever want. You just snap your fingers and boom, there you go. Liquor, cigarettes, beer, food. That's a real happy existence. Yeah. Man, I'm so lucky. I don't know, I'm pretty drunk. I don't give a fuck. Yeah, I don't give a fuck. What the fuss? What, you ain't nothing gonna happen to me. I'm alright. I don't know. I'm so tired, man. Fucking everything. I don't know.